My stomach's growling. Guess I best go out and hunt.
Okay, so am I wearing everything except for what do I do now? I could go level up again. I do want to try and get a better axe. That's a lot of play with. I'll do this. Screw it. Should I pay? Wait. The other one is should I pay? So this is Xiaopai Commandery, Zhu Province. Nestled between the Suxie and Yishu. Suxie and Yishu rivers, this stronghold city poses a stern test to any would-be invader. Inside is a spectacular shrine and tower that a Buddhist warlord had built, and each year extravagant festivities were held there to mark the Buddha's birthday. In winter of AD 200, the city was surrounded by Cao Cao's army, who diverted the river's flow to flood the city. With scores of drowned men strewn before him, the Buddha statue's expression seemed only to say, "All worldly things must perish."
Don't get careless out there.
We must defeat Lu Bu here and stop the chaos. Although we cannot avoid hurting some innocent citizens, I decided to go ahead with our plan to devastate the city by flooding it. The stalemate here has given demons the opportunity to invade the city. This means Lu Bu may have no choice but to turn to his prized elixir. Well, we'll be relying on your abilities. The stalemate here has given demons. This means, well.
Thank you.
fake leather. Nice. Almost didn't say that.
Everything's completely destroyed. The water has slowed down now, but we'll still need to find a path that's not waterlogged. The whole town's totally flooded. I wonder if it's this bad where my brother is.
entire city has been flooded. Are there no lengths that Ker Chow Chow will not stoop to?
Given the season, falling in could be fatal, so watch your feet. My brother and I grew up in was caught in the crossfire of World War II. The house was destroyed, our parents killed, and I could do nothing except cry. But he kept pushing me to keep hope. We supported each other and just about managed to stay alive. Then my master found us and took us to Mount Tianjushan.
Bamboo repeating cross.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take it here. Yeah, let me tell it back. Xiaodun has given you a replica of his cherished equipment after swearing an oath with him. You have received the following items: Vermilion Bird Great Axe, Helmet of Staunchness, Armor of Staunchness, Gloves of Staunchness, Greaves of Staunchness. Greaves of Staunchness. Unscrupulous Hero's Right Hand. Specific resistance, spirit, damage while spirit damage received while attacking, negative 2, spirit consumption, negative 2, poleaxe damage, +6%. Leg guards favored by Xiaodun that combine boots with leather shin guards, ideal for military inspections, leading light cavalry. These greaves omit excess decoration and instead place a heavy emphasis on practicality. Extravagance and fame are a distraction, with his only desire being a world at peace. Xiaodun still stands before his lord, paving the way ahead. I like those. Gloves of Staunchness. Sturdy leather gloves favored by Xiaodun. Bereft of any gaudy adornments, these gloves offer a bare necessity of protection for the arms. The undergarment sleeves are rolled back, exposing the elbows. Though Xiaodun is a celebrated general, he also personally participated in the rebuilding of Luoyang City and engineering to divert floods as well as planting crops to aid the starving citizenry. His rolled up sleeves and strong arms are proof of his humble deeds. Armor Staunchness. Chest armor favored by Xiaodun, featuring feathered shoulder guards over a rigid bright light armor. Upon the thigh guards affixed to the main body is an engraved phoenix pattern as a symbol of auspiciousness. The phoenix motif can also be seen in a belt buckle. Xiaodun's battle successes may not be widely recognized, but he has won many a battle behind the scenes. The phoenix pattern on this armor is a symbol of his unspoken glory. Helmet of Staunchness. A helmet favored by Xiaodun that features a white peasant feather decoration. A sophisticated, sturdy helmet that features simple coloration. Xiaodun was known for his ferocity and gained much prestige throughout the army. He also preferred simplicity, eschewing unnecessary frills. Cao Cao placed a great deal of trust in Xiaodun and treat him as an equal out of respect. Vermilion Bird Great Axe. An iron great axe favored by Xiaodun, a broad axe, has a slashing blade affixed to its head. Long ago, the great axe was given to a general by the Son of Heaven as proof of his trust, and imparted upon him the right to give his own orders during conquest. It adorned with elegant gold motifs of phoenixes and flames. As a child friend of Cao Cao and someone who once saved his life, Xiaodun was trusted by Cao Cao above all others. It cannot be questioned that he has earned the right to hold this glimmering weapon. Stone attack power, power drop on the enemy upon martial arts. Copper opportunity. Hidden undercurrents. Undercut. Undercurrent sprint. Charge into. Okay, so hidden undercuts. Charge forward with your weapon readied in front of you. Additional effect at high speed enhances damage and prevents staggering from incoming attacks except for powerful attacks by enemies. Undercurrent sprint. Charge in the desired direction. Press the arts input while charging to perform a sideways sweeping attack. Thrust your weapon into the ground and use it as a springboard to unleash a kick.
I could use some more sleep. Maybe I'm overworking.
Oops. Bamboo repeating crossbow. A repeating crossbow fashioned from wood and bamboo. This crossbow features a simple construction. It was widely used while fighting the Xiongnu tribes in the former Han period. An iteration on the crossbow used during the spring and autumn and warring states periods. Improved for battle functionality. While it does not deliver the power or range of a typical crossbow, it instead offers ease of use and rapid fire capability. A small contingent of elite soldiers would be quite effective in a ambush using these.
will be on the way to victory. You did well, but that doesn't mean you can relax now.
How do you get over there?
I wonder if we'll ever go back to the days without demons and their chi.
Making sure I've been everywhere.
like this. I'm sorry. With you here, I guess there's nothing to worry about.
How the hell do you get to that?
This is odd. What kind of statue was this? By surprise. Are you all right? Just how weak had that floor gotten to fall through completely? Something troubled him was to turn his back. He's no different now from when he was a child. So, I don't understand why. What led him down this path? I can't deny what he's done. Killing his master, taking the elixir, stirring up conflict. But that's not the Lu Bu I knew. I need to find out what happened, what changed him. My brother was extremely serious about his training in martial arts and wizardry spells. And all because he wanted to protect me. You are my responsibility, Hongjing, is what he'd always say. And it was true, he always looked after me. This time, though, it's I that must become the protector. It's unavoidable that Cao Cao's forces will try to kill him. But if I can get him to stand down, then... Will you lend me your aid? I have no one else to rely on.
Ugh!
occurred to me.
Let me handle this for you.
Never mind. Shame game.